All right, welcome. We're here in the Top Secret Lanes Balance Laboratory at Missouri State University in Springfield, Missouri. What I want to do is give you a little tutorial on lanes balance, which is a very useful thought model for understanding geomorphic systems. Lanes balance is usually portrayed as a figure or a diagram that helps you understand the relationship between the amount of water in a system, the amount of sediment supply to a system, and the relationship between sediment size and stream slope to all these other variables. So the idea here is to give you an opportunity to see an actual lanes balance in operation. Now, what I've done is I've modified a standard beam balance here. We've got T on one side. The T just adds a little color to the water to make it more visual. We've got some rocks that represent the sediment in our system and the beaker on this side. And then we've got our sediment size and stream slope variables represented down here. We can move those left or right. If we want to make our stream slope steeper, we would move the variable out this way. And if we wanted to make our sediment size coarser, we'd move that variable this way. The overall needle here in the center of the system points to what's going to happen to the stream channel. If the needle points to this side, the channel is going to aggrade or fill in its valley and move upwards. If it moves to this side of the dial, it's going to degrade or incise into its valley. All right, so let's play around with the system a little bit. First of all, we can remove a little bit of sediment. That would be the equivalent of reducing the sediment supply to the system, maybe slowing down the rate of hill slope erosion or channel bank erosion or something like that, whatever could cause that. That's going to cause the overall system to degrade and the channel to incise. Less sediment supply, but the same amount of water, the same stream slope, the same sediment size is going to result in net erosion from the channel. Put our sediment back, bring the system to balance. Similarly, if climate changes or we have an unusually dry period and extended drought, we would be putting less water into the system over time. That's going to tip the balance towards the channel aggrading. In this case, we still have the same amount of sediment coming into the system from all the sediment sources in the watershed, but we don't have as much water to move it, so the channel will aggrade. We'll change climate back to what it used to be. So now we're back roughly in balance. Now, if we have finer sediments, say our sediment source changes and the average size sediment entering the fluvial system gets smaller, we would move the variable in this direction. That's going to result in degradation. The channel is going to incise into the floodplain. And that's because we have the same amount of energy, meaning our stream slope hasn't changed. We have the same amount of water, but smaller sediments take less energy to erode. So we'll be able to use that energy that's available to erode more, which will incise the channel. On the other hand, if we decrease the stream slope, if the overall channel slope water slope, the energy in the system is decreased, even with that smaller sediment size and the same amount of water in the system, we'll aggrade the channel. The floodplain will have to build up. The stream won't be able to move all the sediment that's available to it. So as what happens in a natural system is equilibrium is when you change one of these variables, say we take some water out of the system, some other part of the system's going to adjust. Maybe the stream slope will steepen to get the system back into equilibrium, meaning putting the dial back in the middle. Now, this can't happen instantaneously. If we change one of these variables, it's going to take some time for the system to adjust, and the adjustment will occur by tweaking all of these other variables in the system. All right, I hope that helps you understand lanes balance in a little more thorough way. And thank you for paying attention.